Hey guys, it's Stomps here. I'm going to be doing an album review. In this video, I'm going to be reviewing The Who Live at Leeds. Now, I'm not just doing any Live at Leeds. I'm going to be doing the 14-song version. It was originally about 6 songs, but I honestly think that the 14-song version is just really kick-ass. I don't even know what to say, but I just think it like blows away the original. There's also deluxe with Tommy live at Leeds, like they do Tommy live at Leeds, but I'm just talking about the 14 song version. Now the album starts out with a song called Heaven and Hell, which is a John Entwistle song. And it's not all that common to people. It's probably gotten more common over the years, but it wasn't really released on any albums. But I think overall it's a pretty good song. It actually has John Entwistle's really dark side, which is what he basically is. It kind of sounds like a gothic, metalish type of a theme to the song. If you've done nothing wrong. I think it's really cool, but I think the lyrics kind of lack. I don't know if it's on every version, but yeah, the lyrics kind of sound repetitive, and there's not much going on with the lyrics, at least on Live at Leeds, but overall, it's still a pretty good song. All right, man, I can't explain. I love the original, but this one kicks it right in the ass. It's just really hard, rough rocking. And I really like this bass lick that John does in the intro. So yeah, I really love this version. I love their heavy singing, the heavy playing. Keith's drumming is awesome. So I definitely love that song. Next one is Fortune Teller, which I believe is a cover. And I really like it as well. I haven't really focused on the lyrics that much, but I really like the instrument playing. Pete Townshend is now my favorite guitarist, and that's one of my favorite guitar songs. If you just listen to it, the riff sounds beautiful on there. Yeah, and I really like it. Alright, number 4 is Tattoo, which was originally from the Who Sellout. Now, this one, it kind of goes either way. I like the version on here. I've never really been a big fan of this song, but I've started to grow on it a little bit. But I probably prefer more of the original, but I still like the Live at Leeds version. Just they're singing a little bit on part of the song is a little out of key. But it's still a really good version. Welcome to my life, Tattoo. I'm a man, how fast do you? Now here's Young Man Blues, which was the first song on the original Live at Leeds. I actually used to love this song. I still do, but it's just, I've grown tired a little bit. But it's still a really kick-ass song. It has a great guitar solo. And it's no doubt Keith Moon's best drumming. So yeah, awesome song. Next one is Substitute, which is on the original Live at Leeds. It's a really good version. I'm a little disappointed though that it's honestly cut down. They just didn't sing a few verses. It goes down to about 2 minutes, but the original is like 3.5. So I love this version. It's a really nice, hard, rocking, actually, I think it goes better to the song than the original, like how with the lyrics and everything. But it just cut down short. I wish it was as long as the original. Next one is Happy Jack, which, once again, another really hard rocking version. They got good singing. Keith throws in his drums more than the original. Um, It's a good version. Next one. This one could easily be my favorite song on the entire Live at Leeds album. It's called I'm a Boy, which I've actually haven't been that big of a fan of it ever. I liked it in the past, I just didn't love it. Because I just thought it kind of sounded like a little kid's song. But man, the version on here just sounds weird, but it's amazing because it kind of has the lyrics of like a little kid, but they're really rough playing and really like rough vocals just makes the song sound really edgy and crazy. And I just really love it on there. It's one of my favorite performances by them. And like Keith Moon's drumming, the way you hear it, I don't know how he does it. It just sounds really cool. Ride my bike across the street, cut myself and see my blood. I wanna come home all covered in mud. So yeah, I fucking love the version on here. Next one is a quick one, He's Away, which is, we all know that song. And it's a really good version on here. I think it's just as good as the Rock and Roll Circus. Everyone says the Rock and Roll Circus version is the best. I don't really see like all what's crazy about. I still like the Rock and Roll Circus one, but I find versions are just as great. Live at Leeds one is just as good. So. He told me of dreams. Alright, next one is probably the one I don't care as much. I think it's part of the Tommy album. Amazing Journey and Sparks is the song. It's a good song, but there's nothing really that grabs me on it. It's still great playing, but it's just probably the low point in my opinion. Be your leader, be your guide. On the amazing journey together. All right, next one is Summertime Blues, which was on the original Live at Leeds. Now this song's a classic in my opinion. It's probably my favorite on this album. It's a really just great playing overall. Next one is Shaking All Over, which was on the original Live at Leeds again. Nothing too crazy about this song. It's a good song. I really like the singing though, actually, and the guitar playing, but it's nothing too special, but still a good song. Next one is My Generation, which is on the original Live at Leeds. Great version. It's like 15 minutes long. It actually includes a segment of See Me, Feel Me in the middle. Fucking love that song. So I love this version. And I really like Roger Daltrey's vocals on the My Generation. It's just overall great playing on there. Why don't you all fade away? Talking about my generation. Talking what we all about my generation. Trying to cause a bloody big sensation. Talking about my generation. Last one on this album is Magic Bus, which is on the original as well. I'm actually right now preferring towards the original. I just really like the original all of a sudden now, but this one is not bad. It's just kind of just them playing it, but it's around 7 minutes long on this version. And then towards like the middle half, the extra half of the song, it just really kicks up. It's really heavy. It sounds almost like a heavy metal song, I swear. It's some of Keith Moon's best drumming as well. So I honestly love the second half of that song on this version. It's just really killer. It's a good way to end this album.
Chico!
So anyway, sorry if I didn't sound enthusiastic, but this album is really great. I'm not kidding. If you haven't listened to this, you're totally missing out. Just search it on YouTube. Make sure you get the 14-song version. If you hear the original one, that's great, but I honestly feel that the deluxe one has more to offer and honestly lots of great recordings on it. So please check that out. You're honestly missing out on that. So anyway, that's my review. I give it a 10 out of 10. So great Who album.